So today we are going to learn how we'll study about the Compton effect and how will you obtain expression for the Compton shift, that shift in wavelength is del lambda is equals to h divided by m naught c 1 minus cos phi. So for this we have to learn about this diagram. What is the energy of the incident photon, what is the energy of the electron which is in the rest position. We will use the highlighter, laser pointer here. So energy of the incident photon is h mu, okay, and what is the momentum of the photon? Momentum of the photon is h mu divided by c. So this is your electron which is in the rest position. So what is the energy of the electron which is in the rest position? M naught into the c square, and here the electron is in the rest position, that's why its momentum is zero. Now when this electron collide with when this photon is collide with this electron which is in the rest position, this electron will get scattered in this direction. And what is the energy of this electron? This energy is under root of p square c square plus m naught square c to the power 4. So here we have taken p as a momentum of this recoil or this scattered electron or this recoil electron. P is the momentum. And what is the momentum of the incident photon? We have taken it as a h mu divided by c. And this is the direction of the scattered photon. And what is the energy of the scattered photon? H into the mu dash, where mu dash is the frequency of scattered photon and mu is your frequency of the incident photon, and hc divided by lambda dash, this is your energy in terms of wavelength. And what is the momentum of the scattered photon? H mu dash divided by c. So these things we have to use. Okay, now we will move towards our whiteboard, and there I will be explain you about the terms in that diagram. Okay, so here observe that. So this one is your, we'll take black pen. So this is the incident photon. When this incident photon collide with this electron, so what is the energy of the incident photon? Energy of the incident photon is E is equals to h mu. Okay, and what is its momentum? P is equals to h mu divided by c. So where mu, what is this, where what is this mu? Mu is known as your frequency. And frequency of what? Frequency of incident photon, that is the important term. What is mu? Mu is the frequency of your incident photon. Okay, now when this photon collide with this electron, this is the direction of, okay, we'll use black pen, this is the direction of your scattered electron. Now electron is get scattered, so its energy is given by E is equals to under root of p square c square plus m naught square c to the power 4. Okay, and P is known as the momentum. Okay, here important is that we have to taken the momentum of electron is taken as the P, and this electron makes an angle theta with the direction of the incident photon. Now this is the direction of your scattered photon. So okay, now what is the energy of the scattered photon? E is equals to h mu dash. Okay, so here we will take E dash. E dash is the energy of the scattered photon. And what is its momentum? P is equals to the h mu dash divided by c. Okay, here it is the momentum of incident photon. Here P is, it is the momentum of a scattered photon, and P is the momentum of your electron, and this angle is known as your phi. Okay, so important is the terms. So what is this mu? Mu is the frequency of incident photon, and this mu dash is the, what is this mu dash? This is the frequency of scattered photon, frequency of a scattered photon. Okay, so now we'll learn about the terms in this diagram. Now we'll go for the expression. Okay, here I have to write this. Now we'll go for the expression. Now what we have to obtain, the expression for the Compton shift, that is del lambda is equals to h divided by m naught c 1 minus cos phi. Okay, these terms we have to obtain. Now we will move towards our PPT. We'll switch on this whiteboard and on our PPT, and let's go to this. So what happens here, to obtain the expression we have to use the law of conservation of momentum and law of conservation of energy. So first of all, we have to use the law of conservation of energy. So E is the energy we have to take. You have to take energy here before collision and energy after collision. E is the energy of the incident photon, that is E is h mu, and E naught is the energy of your rest mass electron m naught c square. E dash is the energy of the scattered photon h mu dash, and what is the energy of the scattered electron under root of p square c square plus m naught square c to the power 4. So take this square root term on one side and remaining terms on the another side. The equation will be obtained this. In order to remove this square root, we have to square this equation, and by squaring this equation, we have to raise this square root, will get cancelled. So equation will be like this, and this term will get complete whole square h mu mu dash plus m naught c square. These terms will whole square of this term. So if you simplify this term, we'll obtain the expression for p square c square. If you square this term, a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus twice ab, then here m naught c square to the power 4 term is there. This side also m naught c to the power 4 term is there. This term will get cancelled, and we'll obtain the expression for p square c square. So what is the expression for p square c square? P square c square is equals to h square mu minus mu dash whole square plus twice h mu mu dash m naught c square. Here the important term is that here remember one thing is that here what is this mu? Mu is the frequency of incident photon. This is the frequency of your incident photon mu. And what is this mu dash? Mu dash is your frequency of scattered photon. Okay, scattered photon. And what is this p? P is your momentum. Momentum of which? Momentum of electron, scattered electron. And this m naught, m naught is your rest mass of electron. And what is c? C is known as your velocity of light. Okay, so by this law of conservation of energy, we will use eraser here. Okay, so this is, we'll remove this terms. Now we'll use the laser pointer. So by this law of conservation of energy, you will get first equation, that p square c square is this equation. Similarly, on in the same equation, if you use law of conservation of momentum, then we will obtain this expression. Okay, so for this, obtaining the law of conservation of momentum, how will you get horizontal component, how will you get vertical component, we will go for again for the whiteboard. Okay, we'll switch on our whiteboard here and we'll switch off your PPT. Okay, so we'll go for your whiteboard. So now what happens? So suppose this one is your this is the direction of your incident photon, this is your electron. This electron will get scattered in this direction. Okay, this makes an angle theta, and P is your momentum of electron. And what is the momentum of incident photon? H mu divided by C. And this is the direction of the scattered photon. What is its momentum? H mu dash divided by C. This makes an angle phi. So what we have to take? We have to take two momentum. P is your momentum, or if you remove this, okay, you have to take momentum before collision and after collision, or you have to resolve it into the two component. So this P is momentum of this electron, and phi theta is the direction made with the incident photon. Now this momentum can be resolved into two components. This is your vertical component. Vertical, okay, and this one is your horizontal component. So this momentum horizontal component will be P cos theta, and its vertical component will be P sin theta. Okay, now similarly, I have to use red pen here. Okay, similarly, for this photon which is having momentum H mu dash C, its horizontal component will be H mu dash C into the cos phi. Remember that if this H mu dash C is your momentum, this momentum multiplied by cos term is your horizontal component. And what is vertical component in downward direction? This will be your H mu dash C into sin phi. This is your vertical component. Now we'll learn from this diagram is that what we learn, this vertical component, another color, okay, this vertical component is upward vertical component is balanced by the downward component. Okay, and this left side component of the horizontal component balanced by the right side component. Left side is balanced by the right side component, and upward component is balanced by the downward component. So here we'll get the expression now. So what is the left side component for horizontal direction? H mu divided by C equals to, what is the component of the right side? Horizontal component along this along this direction. Okay, this will be, this term will be there. Okay, so this term means P cos theta plus another component is this H mu dash C into the cos phi. So this is your horizontal component. Okay, now from this equation what we'll get? P cos theta is equals to H mu divided by C. This term will get this side, then this will be H mu dash C into the cos phi. Okay, so this is your expression that will gives you the P cos theta component. Okay, similarly, how will you get the sin theta component? Now in order to obtain the sin theta, I have to use green color pen. Okay, so vertical component is balanced by the, this vertical component is balanced by the downward component. So we'll get P sin theta is equals to the H mu dash divided by C into the sin phi. Okay, so this is your one component of P sin theta, and this one is your another component of the P cos theta. Now we'll move towards our PPT. Okay, we'll on PPT and we'll off the whiteboard. Now, what is The first is, so what we have learned is by law of conservation we will get this equation, and by law of conservation of momentum, horizontal component will be p cos theta, vertical component will be p sin theta. So if you square equation number 1 and square equation number 2, here equation number is wrong, changing this equation I have. So if you square this term and square this term, p square cos square theta, okay, and p square sin square theta, and if you add this equation, cos square theta plus sin square theta, that will be equals to 1. So this term, this term will be p square cos square theta if you square this term, and if you square this term, it term will be the p square sin square theta, and cos square theta and sin square theta tick in bracket, and outside p square cos square theta plus sin square theta, that will be equals to your 1. Okay, there is a forward movement. This term will equal to 1, and this will be your p square. Okay, now if you substitute this equation, this a minus b whole square, and this will be h square mu dash square c square sin square theta. Okay, so if you substitute this and if you simplify this equation, you will get expression p square c square is equals to this term. So you will get two terms. By law of conservation of momentum, you will get equation for p square c square, and by using law of conservation of energy, we will get equation for p square and c square. So if you equate these two equation, okay, I have to use now highlighter, okay. If you equate these two equation, so this is your equation first, and this is your equation equation 4 and equation 3. So this equating these two equation, we will get terms on one term in on left hand side, one term on the right hand side. And if you simplify these two equations, if you here, if I now I have to take the pen for your understanding. Suppose this term is there, na? So what happens if you, in this term, if you take h square into the mu square minus h square into the twice mu dash cos phi plus h square into the mu dash square, this term on this side, and this term will be your h square mu square, because it is mu dashed whole square, then plus h square into the mu dash square minus h square into the mu dash. Okay, so here the term h square mu dash, here this side the term h square, I have to use now a highlighter, laser pointer. So here mu dash, here mu dash dash. If this term will goes on that side, it will be positive, and this h square mu dash square, this term will get cancelled, and you will obtain the expression of 1 minus cos phi, and mu dash will get outside. Okay, and if you simplify this equation, we will obtain the equation in this form. This form of equation will be obtained, and this form of equation means what? This equation. This equation will be obtained, 1 upon mu dash minus 1 upon mu is equals to h divided by m naught c square 1 minus cos phi. And what happens, the relation between frequency and wavelength is given by mu is equals to c divided by lambda. Okay, so this is the relation between frequency and wavelength, and if you substitute mu here, mu dash, okay, if I use the pen, his pen there, this mu dash will be replaced with the c, mu is equals to c divided by lambda dash, and this mu will replace with the c divided by lambda. If you substitute this value here, this equation will change to lambda. So lambda dash minus lambda is equals to d lambda is equals to h divided by m naught c. So in this way we will get the expression for this Compton shift, and this value h divided by m naught c, this value is known as your, if this value, This value is known as your lambda c, that is the Compton wavelength, and its value is 0.0242 angstrom. What is this angstrom? Angstrom means 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So this is the value for your Compton wavelength. So you can write this also as the del lambda is equal to lambda c 1 minus cos phi. So in this way we will get the expression for the Compton shift. Okay. So here our Compton effect is over, and we will stop here, and you have to, we will go for the PPT now, and we will switch off this. We will go for this PPT. 1 minute. So what we have learned is that what is Compton effect, whenever what is Compton effect, what is the, how will get the expression for this laser point, for this wave shift in wavelength, and how will get expression for this del lambda. And next we'll learn in next lecture, we have learned about how it is depends upon the scattering angle also phi, and this expression, for expression we have to use law of conservation of momentum, law of conservation of energy. And if you obtain equation for p square c square by law of conservation energy and p square c square by law of conservation of momentum, equating these two equations, we will get expression for the del lambda. Okay, thank you. Now I have to switch.